Also, at the end, for no reason at all, he decides to let everyone know that Greg has the cheese touch, even after Greg's speech. Okay, I know I said this already, but she really needs some help. She just really needs some help. This is why this is my least favorite character. Her mean-spirited is just really annoying and completely ridiculous. And if her mother is the president of the PTA, then there's something wrong with her as well. There's also an additional character named Angie. She's okay. I don't have a problem with a new character appearing in the movie that he or she wasn't in the book, but she's fine for what she is. She takes pictures on the news article, and she sometimes give advices to Riley and Greg, and I kind of like her for that reason. She's kind of likable, but in a very generic way, she's okay. She's not terrible, she's okay. I should talk about the mean-spirited stuff in this movie. Now, I really don't understand where they're going with this. I mean, in the book, there was no mean-spirited stuff, but in this, it kind of takes it a little too far. I mean, I know that this kid really doesn't like Greg and Riley, but I can understand why not liking Riley. But if Greg is at the 19th scale during this time in the movie, then why does he doesn't deserve to be on the table? I just don't understand this. Even though he will be on the table, he will eat at the lunch table in the next movie, but for this movie, it just doesn't work. I can understand why people can't be cruel in this movie, and they just don't give the main characters a chance, but it just doesn't work as the fact that Greg was in the 19th scale during this part of the movie. I should talk about the relationship between Greg and Rowley. Like I said, Greg and Rowley valued vastly different things, but Greg decides to help Rowley to become popular at school, even though that he really wants to be a class favorite. Rowley isn't like the same as Greg. I mean, he's more fun-loving, and he always has a lot. He wants a lot of stuff at Christmas, and he has different things. Like, he really loves her mother a lot, and they don't have the same value that Greg has. During points in the movie, like during Halloween and other stuff, they're trying to make it the best thing ever, even though next year they're gonna say the same thing again and blah blah blah. But anyways, I really like this friendship a lot. In fact, it's one of the strongest things in this movie. And the best thing about this is that they completely nail it in perfection. They did the exact same way that the book did, with no changes whatsoever in this plot. And I really like it for that reason. Greg can't be a jerk to Rowley, but Rowley can be likable. In fact, one of the best scenes in this movie is when Rowley decides to think that Greg isn't much of a good friend, considering the fact that he really doesn't like anything that Rowley has to offer.
You know what, Greg? You're not a good friend. Whoa, how could you even say that? I'm a great friend. If you were a great friend, you would have told Mr. Winsky the truth. Okay, one thing. You can't get mad about this. You only care about yourself. You hated my cartoon. You made fun of my clothes. You disrespected Joshy. You broke my hand and you didn't even seem sorry. That broken hand was the best thing that ever happened to you. Don't call me. Don't come by my house. We're done.
That scene alone is just perfect. The people who made this movie can make Rowley a more serious character. Like, he isn't fun-loving and carefree and not like the same as Fred. He can be very serious at times. Greg just, even though that he may accidentally broke his arm, but he really made fun of his cartoons, his dresses, and he really disrespected Joshy. That really hurts Rowley a lot, and I really like the scene for many reasons. At the end of the movie, the three teens finally get their hands on Rowley and Greg, and they forced them to eat the cheese. Well, Riley did eat the cheese, but Coach Malone Massa stopped this. Which I really thought that this was going to be the end for Riley, but Greg decides to defend Riley and thank that everyone and for everyone that he ate the cheese instead of Riley. That to me really changed Greg as a character. Even though he keeps going down the scale a lot, but he managed to become a class favorite in this school. And that's why I really like the pairing in this movie. Even though some of the minor stuff that happens, I can still like it, even though the major problems can kind of make this movie a little less very great. If you want to know what I mean by that, is that getting better, but just becoming less great than being very great. But anyway, I really enjoy this movie a lot. In fact, it's one of my favorites. It's better than the other sequels. These sequels aren't bad, but they're still good. Also, I did check the cast from the Long Haul movie that's coming out in 2017. In fact, they really made the actors really good, like they did in this movie. In fact, I can't believe that I did research, and the actors from the new actors who are gonna play in the next movie are really good and really amazing to that they kind of look similar to the original actors. I really can't wait to see what they're gonna have in store in the next movie in 2017. Anyway, I give Diary of a Wimpy Kid an 8 out of 10. I'm Lonely Fanboy Foyer here, and I'll see you next time.